All right. So, Mr. Ambassador, you know, U.S.-Russian relationships are already strained. How is this going to affect the tense relationship between Washington and Moscow? It's already tense.
Well, it's certainly not going to make it any better. And I think the fact that President Obama was actually on the phone today with President Putin when the plane went down, or at least when the first reports came out, indicates the degree to which the United States and Russia are going to need to stay in close contact, despite the difficulties involved in that. The United States just yesterday announced a new round of sanctions against Russia over its support for the pro-Moscow separatists in Ukraine. It's been trying very hard to get the Europeans on side with those sanctions, because without them, it could disadvantage American companies, which would lose their business. Now, I think the fact that you've had a civilian plane shot down with hundreds of Dutch, German, French citizens may have the effect of galvanizing the European resolve a bit more than had been the case. And I agree with something that I think Fareed said earlier. This is now an opportunity. You'll have a probably 2 or 3 day ceasefire for humanitarian reasons to allow the recovery of remains and hopefully some sort of international investigation to go on. That's an opportunity to expand it into a longer ceasefire and get to the negotiated settlement, which is the only way that this conflict will be settled.
Mm-hmm. And as of now, as we're on the air now, we know that it's 154 people from the Netherlands. There was 45 citizens from Malaysia, and then Australia, 27. They lost the most. There are still people who are unidentified. If it turns out that there are Americans on board this plane, how does the U.S. response change then, if at all?
Well, if there were Americans on board, the first response comes from the U.S. Embassy in Kiev, which has the responsibility to try to identify the remains and facilitate contact, notify the loved ones. There's a lot of embassy work that needs to get done, first and foremost. There'll be time, I think, to look at the political and policy ramifications of all of that later on. But I think if it turns out that there were Americans on board, it makes it as much of a tragedy as if there weren't Americans on board. Mm-hmm. You've had a tremendous catastrophe, civilian human catastrophe, take place in a war zone in a war that really doesn't need to be taking place. And I think, as I said earlier, there should be an opportunity now, if there's a will in Moscow and in Ukraine, I believe there is a will in Ukraine, to actually sit down and begin to talk this through and work it out. Yeah.